production. Well, you guys, I have to admit, I was a little bit nervous backstage. To be honest, I've never officially introduced an act, so I didn't really know how to do it. So I figured, hey, maybe I'll bring a couple of my friends, and then they can help me out. Yay, therapy! So, once upon a time, in a land far, far away, there was this beautiful princess, and her name was, let's just say Penny. And she was the most beautiful girl in all of the land. But she wasn't conceited. So Penny decided to travel. She wanted to travel to a magical place, a place where almost anyone can get totally roofied, blackout, and then wake up in a hotel room with a midget masturbating in the corner. So she decided to visit Las Vegas! Yay! And after a three-week-long coke binge, she ended up at Spiegel World, right where you're sitting, and she was like, oh wow, oh my goodness! Actually, it was more like, whoa, my fucking god! She came and said, oh my god, look at those fucking lights in here. It's so fucking bright. Look at the shit hanging around. Look at all the drunken people tonight here. You have sex without protection and get gonorrhea or herpes. You just say woo for herpes? Okay. No one fucked that guy. So, all of a sudden, something caught her eye in the tent. And she looked over and there's this Russian acrobat that was just like standing there all serious. And he was so hot, just standing there. And she was like, oh my god, what the fuck is wrong with him? And nothing was, he was just Russian. So she was totally checking him out, right? And then all of a sudden he turned his head and then he started checking her out. So there was all this like sexual tension between them, you know? Just like Donnie and Marie Osmond. And then they started walking to each other really slowly, you know? And he was like, oh, excusez-moi, but you have the most beautiful thing I've ever seen in my life. And she said, wait a minute, were you supposed to be Russian? Yes, but I cannot do a Russian accent, and this French one is the only one I can kind of half-ass do, so I said, fuck it, bitch. And because he was being so aggressive, gosh, for no reason, and calling her names, and so totally aggressive, she started to fall in love with him. And they started getting closer and closer. Oh, they were so close they could smell each other's essence. You know, it was so hot. And she smelled him, and he smelled her, and he smelled like communism and Axe body spray. And she smelled like strawberry shortcake and shame. And then they went closer and closer. And finally their lips touched, and finally they kissed. And it was so beautiful, you guys. It was like an explosion going off, you know? Like from a big unicorn's penis or something. And they looked at each other and she said, oh gosh, I love you. Oh my god, I can't believe I said that, but it's true. And I wish there was a way that we could stay together forever and ever and ever and ever. So she pulled down his pants and totally started giving him a BJ right then and there. She didn't give a fuck who was watching. She was just like eating that shit like it was a Snickers bar, man. She was just like going at it, you know? She even took her mouth off it, and a little bit of spit just connected from his dick to her mouth, you know? It was like a little piece of spaghetti, and she was totally like a lady in a trampy, you know? She was like, so she slurped it back. She was like, and she was like the Cookie Monster before dicks, you know? She was just like, and he was like, all right, Penny! Fuck yeah! Hey, you wanna get the balls a little? All right! Well, you know what we Russians like to do? And she said, and he said, but we Russians, we also like to give back to our lovers. He dove right in, started eating out of muff, you know? And she's just watching and making sure he's doing that shit properly, because the guy can really fuck that shit up. But he was so good. He was moving all the hair out of the way, you know? Like, really trying to get in there, just like spreading pussy juice everywhere. It was awesome. And then he was really trying to find a clitoris, you know, the mysterious clitoris. Like, where is it? What the fuck is it, you know? And then he finally found it, and there it was so beautiful. It was like the Pearl of the Nile. He started blowing on it. Ooh, she started twitching a little bit. He started blowing, ooh. She was like, oh god, just touch it. She started sweating in all these weird places, you know, like her butthole. And then he was like blowing on it more. And then she was like, oh god, just touch it. And finally he touched it. And then she turned into a demon. She was like, whoa. Yes, you all shall obey me now, motherfucker. You better fuck me now, bitch. He started fucking her. And they're doing like this aggressive acrobatic shit. It was awesome. She was like, yeah, now throw me in the air and catch me with your dick. Yeah. Bouncy, 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 bouncy. Oh, am I going to think about my dad? Am I going to think about my dad?
thank you. Good enough. Good enough. Thank you. Penny Gibbons. Yay, therapy. Thank you, Penny. Just for the Republicans, we're starting to enjoy the show again. Good job.
I'm so sorry. I think I just peed a little bit.
Alright, disgusting.
Maybe it's not pee.
Alright. No, not gonna smell that. Thank you. There was no intro for this next act in any of that shit that you just said. And also fail on that account. Ladies and gentlemen, madames et messieurs, maintenant nous présentons le poisson de la baguette.